What do you do?
Oh yes. You see, I am a traveling singer. I help out get money by singing for people. Pretty simple, but
Really?
it's good. Yeah.
Would you mind singing us a song now? I'm very curious as to how to see how lovely your voice is.
Oh, I sure thing. What do you want me
Okay.
to sing?
Oh, do you know The Long Road Ahead? It's a pretty common
Absolutely.
folks. Yeah, it's a
Oh,
common folk song.
absolutely.
Mila, do you
I
need
was about to say
accompaniment or?
absolutely. I would love that.
Oh, all
Okay.
right. You gotta. Okay, so both of you do a perform check, and since Squee's playing music and you're accompanying her, I'll give you a +10% to both your checks since you're synergizing with each other.
Ooh.
All right.
Oh, good. I made it. Woohoo! Barely.
There is that.
Got +10%. So what did you got get there, Kriana? Not quite, not quite, but that's okay. You had a 50%, you got 62. So we'll just chalk it up to you never really sang accompanied with Squee before, so the timing was a little off. You know what I mean? Like he had to catch up to you or you had to catch up with him. But you maintained the same song and you were able to, sing the entire thing to completion. He's Baron is extremely pleased. And the next broach of conversation is of are you folks looking for work?
Actually, funny you should say that.
Hmm.
Mila and I would like a squirrel.
And he was eating cake at this point, and he chokes a little bit on it. He goes, I'm sure you could catch one. They're not that
My
difficult.
character is like kind of like looking at them with sort of like a deadpan. He's obviously slowed his chewing.
Mila's just nodding her head, like, yeah.
Let me be more specific. We happened to
Okay.
visit the tent of, was it the Cyberworks? The Cyberworks
Oh,
tent.
yes, Cyberworks Incorporated, yes.
And we were browsing their products, and we might be interested in purchasing something from them. However, it is quite a, let's say, lucrative proposition for them. So,
Oh, so you're looking for work to pay for that, hmm?
possibly. Depends on
Ah,
the work.
Cyberworks. Fair enough, fair enough. Well, obviously there are a few options for you. If it's just raw money that you need, many other groups find a lot of success. To the north of here are quite a few old ruins of old cities that happened before the rifts. And if there's one thing all new cities, all civilizations here in our new world need, it is metals, electricity, plumbing. It doesn't happen out of thin air for the most part. You require some of that. And copper is very useful. And many, according to my research, many of the old homes were lined with this stuff. As long as you have yourselves a mean to carry it, which I believe you do there, Patrick, if I remember from where the Borg, the now sold Borg was laying, you certainly have the capacity to do that. It requires some grunt work, and some of the runes can be quite deadly, but you can make yourself a very good haul with that. Also, this morning, one of the farmers, half of his livestock was killed by something, and I was going to send a section of my militia here to investigate. However, I'd feel much more comfortable in having them stay here and guard the inhabitants and pay some mercenaries to look after this threat, find out, track down who killed half the slaughter. I'd be able to pay you a sizable bounty for that. There is another option, though, that whirled through my head when I listened to your singing. Now, this isn't very lucrative, at least not at first, but it most certainly can be with time. And it will give you the opportunity, well, a lot of opportunity, let's just say. I sponsor a traveling minstrel show. Entertainment. Singers, performers, acrobatics. But the big pièce de résistance, he says, is I collect pre-war movies. And I, along with the traveling minstrel show, we go town to town for money, and we charge people to see these movies. I set up this fantastic large screen and play a movie for a few hours after a stage performance, and everyone just eats it up. It started out very small a few years ago, but it's building up quite a bit of ground. I know that you, Enchanting Mila, can certainly carry a tune, and you, Doctor, not only can play the guitar quite well, but having a traveling show would be very useful to have some medical expertise as well, because it is in the wild, and people do end up getting hurt. In addition, a lot of the towns that you would visit don't have their own doctor, and you'd be able to do a lot of good there. You, Patrick, I imagine, if you like oddities and pre-riffs artifacts as well, there's much of it in my vault, and it's not doing anyone any good just sitting there. I was always thinking of starting some sort of, I guess you could say, sideshow where people could come in and see and feel and touch and experience what it was before the riffs happened. Perhaps even in some of the more open-minded towns, you could show or even sell some magical items. I would need a trusted curator to know what the heck, you know, to tell people what it is. And by your discussion on my picture there, I have a feeling that you're incredibly knowledgeable. And
I've dabbled a bit. I've searched a few things of my own, mm-hmm. as you've probably heard from me discussing. Still kind of wolfing down food. That's what my character's doing, not what I said. Anyway.
Yeah.
I've actually acquired and marked down what the objects I have, and if you're talking about that you have like a movie theater, I think you might want to add another one to that section, because I just sold one.
Oh, excellent. Excellent.
By the looks of it, it's really good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But for you, Tom, now, I need to know a little bit more about you. And I apologize if it seems that I pry, but we all know that you're psionically gifted. But what exactly can you do? He asks with curiosity.
Do you promise that nobody will shoot me? Or anything?
I guarantee you, I give you my solemn vow, and he puts his hand over his heart.
Okay. And we're still at the dinner table, right?
Oh, yes, we're still, yep. They are on the dessert course at this point.
All right. I'm just going to bring my hand up in front of my face and let it ignite. And then wave it.
You're igniting your face?
My hand.
Oh, glow. Okay.
Because you can do that too, but I was like, what? All right, you're igniting your hand.
Yeah.
He goes, oh, a fire starter, huh?
Mm-hmm. Then I close my hand and it extinguishes.
Our traveling show has two psionically gifted individuals. One is very good at healing and reading minds and auras and doing some prophecy. But one of them is very similar to you. Of course, he operates as a fire eater since flame can't hurt him. And he's quite acrobatic as well. Mm-hmm. I'm sure you could always use a protege. If you're interested, you could always team up with him. and at least make some money that way. Of course, my traveling show, this minstrel show, only stops in... It travels for 4 months at a time, and then stops here for a month to resupply, and then a month to practice their act. They're going to arrive here in about a month's time, and if you folks care to join up, I think it'd be a fine opportunity for you. And as an added bonus,
I was gonna say, I look at Patrick a little concerned, and then I say, I have a question. When they travel to these towns, would there ever be time, say, for example, if we were happened to be near a ruins or an area, would there ever be days to ourselves where we could go exploring?
Oh, of course. Of course. That's the whole thing. The Traveling Minstrel Show doesn't go on a strict schedule. It doesn't have to be here at a certain time or here at a certain time, and you're not on the road the entire time. In fact, in order for us to make a profit on one of these small cities, we have to be there for a week, perhaps even two. And the acts don't run nonstop. You will most certainly have at least a few days to yourself to explore. And the always nice thing is, as long as you promise to come back, you can always have other entertainers to substitute for you. If it's money that you're wondering about, though, I don't know so much about Cyberworks, to tell you the truth. He says, I've let them set up a tent there, but I don't know much about them. If you were willing to trust me, I'd purchase that squirrel, he says, with kind of still surprise in his voice. He goes, I could purchase that squirrel for you, and you can, and we can factor that as a part of your salary. So I wouldn't actually pay you a living wage like I do the other people, but you would still be able to have the same supplies of the caravan itself. It's an option. They're not going to be here for another month at least. So think about it. Give it a good thought. I just think that I pride myself in being able to spot talent, and I think you'd be able to fit in. I can have any thug get copper wire for me, and any mercenary band can hunt down a supernatural demon. But people who can sing, people who can read, people who know about the past, and people who can conjure fire on their hands are very rare. And I think you'd be better served that way. But that's just me.
I'm sitting next to Al, and I'm going to gently nudge his ribs with my elbow and slightly raise my eyebrows.
Well.
Yeah, I don't need a decision right now. Not at all.
One more question. We have a fifth member of our party. You may know of her. Her name is Alicia. She was a caravan guard.
Is she the very skinny woman that entered Perrin's Post with you?
Yes.
Yes. How's she doing? I heard that she had some trouble.
She's weak. She's malnourished. She had a run-in with a... I'm sorry, Patrick, what was that thing again?
Oh, which one?
What?
The magical thing I shot in the eye, yeah.
Yes. Witchling.
A witchling. She's fine, but she needs to eat and rest. But afterwards, she's with us. So anywhere we go, there would need to be a place for her as well.
Oh, not a problem. You said she was a caravan guard previously? If she can't sing or dance or do acrobatics... A traveling show always requires security. I can make sure there's a spot for her.
Okay. We appreciate the offer, and I'm sure we will certainly take it into our thoughts account.
That's all I ask. Are you staying anyplace tonight? He asks.
I don't think we've actually made arrangements yet.
Well, I would be honored if you would be my guests and stay here for the night. I can't promise you this generosity every single day, but for tonight, you can definitely stay here free of charge if you like.
I'd rather sleep here than in the car again.
Works for me.
I mean, it's comfy, but...
Works for me.
All right, then we will gladly accept your offer, sir. Perrin.
Wonderful. Fantastic. Wonderful. Well, I'll let you go to your evenings. I'll let some of my staff here, my modest staff here, show you, where your rooms are. Of course, you don't have to retire for the night at all right now. But feel free. I'll let the guards at the front here know that you're staying here tonight. So you can come and go as you please.
Okay.
Cool.
I'm going to have myself a nice cigar and a brandy by the fire if you care to join me. But other than that, I want to thank you for having dinner with me. It's always nice to talk with new people.
Finally getting the last of his obviously like three courses that he...
yeah.
Oh, yeah. If you have time tonight, I would love to just kind of poke around and see what you have in the pre-war thing. Well, that one.
He goes, okay, we can discuss that. You have to admit, though, you are still very strangers, very much strangers to me. I'll need to guarantee.
Sorry if I come off as eager.
Oh, no, eagerness is fine. It's just... Oh, no, I've had run-ins in the past is all, so I'm very protective of what I've accumulated over the years. Tell you what. Once you decide for sure that you'll be my curator for the traveling show, then I'll let you see. But until then, it might have to stay a private collection.
I'm going to say the more Perrin talked, the... quieter and quieter and I guess darker is what I guess what I'd say Al's expression got, and he's just been very quiet this whole time, like thinking.
Okay, fair enough.
Can Mila notice that?
Of course, everyone could notice that. Okay. It's as plain as the nose on his face.
Okay, could she like go over and be like, Hey, what's wrong? Hey.
I'm going to need to talk to you guys tonight.
Us?
Yes. Oh. You, okay. Our group. And that includes Alicia.
All right. Okay. How come?
Just later tonight.
Okay.
Yeah, it is a bit late. I don't think we can actually travel out to do anything.
You do have an appointment around 8 o'clock with that fellow from CyberWorks in the bar, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
So I would probably, like pull everyone aside. And then, well, we're right next to the clinic, so we could go there. If everyone's fine, I'd like to, like, maybe go to the clinic, so Alicia's there, too, and get to a corner out of the way, so it's just us.
Sure. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can definitely arrange that. We can move that to be our next scene, if you like.
Mm-hmm.
Who?
Okay.
All right, so I guess we'll skip ahead.
One last thing. Before we skip ahead to that, as you guys finish up your meal and you head to the door, I just want to do one last thing. Perrin says, Tom, can you come here for a second? Just away from the others. I just have a quick question for you.
Mm-hmm.
And he kind of looks around just a little nervous, and for the first time Perrin, the finger doesn't seem as calm and collected as he has been. And he kind of leans over and he whispers, he goes, do you, the other two guys in your group, are they with Mila at all?
Tom just stares at him with a blank face. What do you mean? They're standing right there.
No. Perrin says, no, I mean like romantically,
Uh-huh.
So they're not? They're not?
I don't know.
You don't. Oh, okay. Okay. All right. Okay. I was just curious. Okay. Have a good night. Have a good night. And Perrin retire. Leaves. What?
They're
with each other.
This is just cackling in the back.
I could just imagine, like, if Burn was like, "How do you know I'm not with her?"
Well, see, that was
jerk.
I gave him the opportunity to say that,
right?
But I figured I'd just go with that.
Just because.
All right. Anyways, yeah. so now we can move on to the next scene.
Okay. I guess. I would take you all to the clinic, and so Alicia's there, and then we're by ourselves. And mm-hmm. I guess Al would be very hesitant. Like, he's really trying hard to think, or a better way to put it is fighting with himself as to what he should say and what he shouldn't. So okay. I'm basically just going to start this way. I don't know about you guys, but the offer to go with the traveling group seemed like a fantastic offer for me. But it's also a really bad one because when I met you guys, we didn't know much about each other. We still don't, really. But you guys were just people I traveled with. And I'm starting to look at you guys more than that, like friends. And I have a very, very, very hard time. I don't know what I can say and what I can't. But I haven't been entirely honest with you guys as to my past. And there could be, no, there will be people looking for me. And these could be very, very dangerous people. And it could put you guys in danger too. And I might have been willing to do that with acquaintances. I don't know if I'm willing to do that with friends. And the idea of traveling with this group and traveling with you guys even more, I don't like the idea of putting you in danger because of me. But I also don't like the idea of parting with you guys. And I also can't tell you exactly what I'm talking about. I can't. But I want you guys to make a choice for yourselves. Staying with me in the group could be very, very dangerous.
All right. I have a general simple question.
Okay.
If these people were to find you, would we have a chance of fighting back? Or would it be more of like a they found us and all of the things that we know and love will perish immediately?
I'm good enough at my job that if anyone finds me, it's going to be the type of person that you don't see coming. It's not going to be a bunch of tanks and armies and hellfire and brimstone. It's going to be someone you don't expect at a time you least expect it, and it's going to be a knife in the back. And I
Assassin's
think...
It's fantastic.
Sorry, just like you said. Oh, Assassin's!
Like how...
Okay.
Instantly... well...
I think I can stay ahead, but I can't promise it.
Well... You're not the only person that is being chased by a huge evil thing. I'm just saying.
Wait. Can you guys Mila, running like, from ghosts?
I was going to say, can Mila look over at Patrick and be like, who's chasing you?
You first.
The only difference, Al, is the people who are trying to hunt me are the people with tanks and dirigibles and things like that that you will see coming a mile away.
Huh. So no ghosts.
No ghosts, no.
Alicia sits up from her bed. She looks Al square in the eye. She says, "You saved my life. I don't give a shit if it's God that's coming for you. I'll blow his fucking head off. Don't worry about me. I'm sticking with you until our debt's clear."
And I want... Tom immediately goes up to her and puts out his hand to high-five her.
She gives it a tap. She doesn't know what you're doing. She kind of taps it with her fingers and she goes, "Yeah."
She's gonna stand there?
Who?
Tom.
No, I she does that. I look at my hand and I go, "Huh." Then I look down and go back to where I was standing.
Okay.
I'm still waiting to hear what you two think.
Right. About all of that. Well, let's see. Odds of survival, about the same with or without you. I think I would like you around. Yeah, that'd be good.
I like kind of widen my eyes. Exactly what kind of ruins do you explore?
It's, the magic kind.
I thought you were going to say the best kind.
Did you not see the ghost person? Do you think I could take that thing on by myself? I don't think so.
Well, that I didn't think that was your usual sort of customer. It's definitely not mine.
When you hang around magic stuff, everything's your customer.
That's good to know.
Nice. Quote of the day. When you hang around magic stuff, everything's your customer. Also, is she with you? Well, she's standing right over there with them. Is that what I think?
I really should have said she's with all of us. Oh, God, I really should have.
Anyway, anyway, sorry, no, but we're still waiting for Mila to respond to Squeeze Outpour.
Yes. Mila's going to turn to Al and... very sweetly, but also, like, with kind of some hidden determination, she's going to say, we won't let anyone hurt you, basically. Aww. We won't let anyone hurt you. I'm so tired. I'm from the Southern accent. I sound like...
Don't worry about it.
Hank Hill, no. I won't let...
Boomhauer?
Boomhauer, yes.
What?
I do not have any sexual relations with that hamster.
Right. So guys, are we going to join the circus?
I would love to.
Okay.
Patrick?
Yeah, let's do it.
Why not?
Well, it does give me some company.
Yes. And... no, you want to say yes. Come on.
Hey, Alicia, we're joining the circus.
What?
One thing though.
We're doing this to get a squirrel. Can you believe it?
One thing though.
And
like,
then she sits up a bit more and says, "What?"
And then Al gets serious again. But one thing. If we're going to be traveling with others, and if we do have people after us, we have to promise not to let our problems inflict them. If we're traveling with the circus, we have to do everything we can to make sure our issues do not bring pain, ruin. I don't know the word to say, but you understand what I mean.
Mm-hmm. Alicia nods. She understands.
Mila nods, but everyone's not entirely sure she really understands. Or she's just not part of the consensus.
She might just still be thinking about the squirrel. Yeah, squirrel. Yeah,
that's right. We're getting a squirrel.
For the... In response to Al's comment, for the first time since you've known him, Tom looks straight at him with no emotion, completely deadpan, and says, "I will not let anybody get hurt."
Curiously. Okay.